Is this new autonomous agriculture drone the future of farming in Brazil? I'm here now in front of a beautiful rice field in the rural neighborhood of Vila Nova in the city of Joinville in the southern Brazilian state of Santa Catarina, and today we're going to try to answer that very question. The autonomous agriculture drone featured in this episode of Rice Farming TV has some pretty impressive specs. It weighs 55 pounds, 25 kilos, and holds 4 gallons, 15 liters, of tank mixture. The drone requires 4 batteries and has a flight duration of 15 minutes with a full payload. With 6 spray nozzles, the drone can autonomously spray 2.5 acres, 1 hectare, per flight, or 15 acres, 6 hectares, per hour of operation. Later in the video, we'll find out how this application rate compares to an average traditional tractor spray boom operation here in this region of Brazil. This particular drone is a tool used by Agrize, a precision farming and agricultural information technology company that is based in Vila Nova, Joinville. They have invited me into their office to see how the field mapping and coordinate generation is done before the autonomous drone takes flight. A computer application called Mission Planner, which resembles Google Earth, provides satellite imagery of the targeted field. With a simple click of the mouse, a perimeter can be drawn around the field or a portion of the field. The program automatically generates waypoints and illustrates the flight path of the drone. All this information is communicated wirelessly from Mission Planner to the drone. You do not need to physically map the field as was required by the autonomous agriculture drone previously featured in episode 41 of Rice Farming TV. Link to that demonstration is in the description. Once the flight map has been generated and communicated to the drone, we just need to set everything up on location at a local rice farm containing an Agrize managed test plot. Since the mapping was done back at the Agrize office, the drone automatically links up to the waypoints and begins its precision spray application. A lot of people ask how the prop wash from the drone's rotors affect coverage. As you can see here, and in my opinion, the coverage is excellent and uniform as the prop wash actually exposes more of the plant to the spray application. Although after the rice is harvested, we will have to check back in with Agrize to see their final results with this test plot. Anyway, let's get back to just admiring this drone and this technology in action. Just as the application of this test plot concludes, the host farmer has invited us to fly the drone alongside his spray tractor in another nearby rice field. Let's head over closer to his barn and talk to him to find out what application rate he can achieve with his equipment.
Olá, eu sou fazendeiro também. De arroz.
De arroz também? Da onde?
Sim, Califórnia, a norte da Califórnia.
Ele gostaria de perguntar quantos hectares faz por hora o chupa-cabra?
Por hora? 7.
7 hectares.
6, 7 hectares por hora. Depende de máquina para máquina, de operador também.
De operador também, né?
Claro.
Área, se a área é grande, área menor.
E você está fazendo, Igor, quanto?
6 hectares por hora de operação.
Parecido, né?
Parecido.
So as this Brazilian rice farmer mentions, depending on a few variables, he can, on average, cover about the same as Agrize's autonomous agriculture drone. Can we call the drone the future of farming in Brazil? It has its place, absolutely. But this equipment and service will not flood the market and immediately replace tractors, that's for sure. A longer flight time and larger payload would be necessary for such a dramatic transition. Farmers are also traditionalists, so convincing a farmer to adopt new technology can be challenging. Right now, Agrize is doing excellent work and data collection that will help with this hurdle. A benefit is that here in this region of Brazil, the average rice farm is about 75 acres, 30 hectares. So a drone this size could certainly cover that area over the course of a few days. Definitely in tandem with the farmer's existing tractor spray boom operation. The drone is also a great resource here because aerial spray applications by crop dusters has been completely restricted due to safety. What I can say with absolute certainty is that from a technological standpoint, it's an exciting time to be in agriculture. The future of agriculture certainly will incorporate autonomous drones, tractors, and robots. Right now, we're just getting a taste of what's to come. Perhaps in the near future, even an Android will be producing and hosting YouTube farming videos for you to enjoy.
Thank you for watching. Hasta la vista, baby.
Let me know down below what you think about this particular autonomous agriculture drone and the future of farming. We certainly have come a long way over the last decade.
It would be better if I filmed from the other side of that little toe ditch. You don't think I can do it?
I know, responsabilidade.